So after launching Storyboard Pro, the welcome screen opens. And this is the window where you can both create a new project and open projects. So in the Create a New Project section, the first field is project name. So let's name our project Animated Series. And the reason that it fills in for both the project name and the project title is because the project name is the file name, whereas the project title is what appears on PDF exports. However, you can change the project title if you wish. The second field is project directory, and this is where you would like to store your project on your computer. So if you're not satisfied with the default choice, you can always click on the browse button to browse to a different place or directory on your computer. So the next field is the project subtitle, and this is where you would put any additional titling as well as special mentions. So in fact, a better example for the project title and the project name would be episode 12, and then the project subtitle could be something like holiday special. So you can see by the examples that I used why it might be useful to have a field for the project name, the project title, and the project subtitle. So here we select the resolution of our project, which is also known as the camera size. So once again, if you're not satisfied with the default choice, you can click on this down arrow to see a list of other camera sizes and select one from the list. And just below it, the width, height, and frame rate are also listed for that camera size selection. So obviously the width and height are given in pixels, the frame rate in frames per second, and the field of view is the alignment of images when imported. So in this case, horizontal. And none of these selections are editable. The way that you would change these is by selecting a different camera size. And they change automatically. So these fields you cannot enter in to make changes, but are really just related information to the camera size. If you do want to make a custom camera size, you need only to click on this plus button here, and it'll use the currently selected camera size as a starting point, and then you can change the name, so you can say custom, and then maybe make something very, very strange, I don't know, maybe like a square or something like that. You know, you can change the horizontal or vertical fit. You can change your frame rate per second to whatever you want, and then say create. So now that exists in your list, so it's here at the top. And if you want to delete it, of course, you can just click on this minus button right here, and it deletes that custom camera size. The next section we have is the recent project section. So this lists any of the projects that you've recently worked on. So here we see three, but the list could be quite long, or if you're launching Storyboard Pro for the first time, you might not see any recent projects at all. So if I wanted to open one of these projects, I would just need to click on the link indicated right here. If you'd like to open a project that you've previously created, but that does not appear in the recent projects list, you simply need to click on the Open Projects button, and a browser window will open, which will allow you to navigate to a place on your computer where you have a project saved. So the last two items in the welcome screen are the support links. So if we click on the first one, it takes us to the Storyboard Pro video tutorial page where you can learn to use Storyboard Pro by following these videos online. The second link takes you to the support page where you can get all sorts of help and information on how to use Storyboard Pro. So let's create this project because there's one last thing that I'd like to show you. So if for some reason you'd like to access the welcome screen after you've created your project, you just have to go to the top menu and go to Help, Show Welcome Screen. And you can bring it up again once you've created your project in the software.